Okay, some gift ideas for photographers for about under $100. Now, today I'll give you some ideas to maybe like direct recommendations, but also just some ideas to steer you in the direction you kind of want to go with your gift giving. Now, I'm assuming most of you watching this aren't photographers, so something you should know about photographers is everything they lust for is in the thousands. So buying something that is under $100, it has to be good. So that's why you're watching this video. Let's start with memory. Number one of my favorites are these little hard drives. They're about $100. I'm kind of cheating, might be 99, 110, 120. these can hold lots of photos, and photographers can edit off these tiny little SanDisk hard drives. So try to get a little SSD drive for your photographer. They'll appreciate an SSD drive. For just a regular SD memory card, this is a good one. This is SanDisk, any kind of SanDisk. This is 128 megabytes. Megabytes? Gigabytes. You can get them, it's not that exciting, but you can get them a brand new fast card reader. So instead of plugging the cards into their computer, this is called a pro-grade card reader. It can hold two different types of cards. So you could look at card readers for them. Next, you could get them a nice camera bag for under $100. And if you don't know anything about camera bags, it's a very personal choice. So make sure you have the gift receipt. But also, anything by ThinkTank is an excellent value and is built super great and will be appreciated by a photographer. So one of my favorite tiny, less than $100 camera bags is called the Mirrorless Mover. And they come in all kinds of sizes, so you have to know what kind of camera do they have. Do they have a tiny? If they have a tiny camera, I would recommend the Mirrorless Mover 30, because it allows you to put the camera in with a lens and one or two extra lenses. So this is the Mirrorless Mover line. And this one's a little bit more expensive, but very trendy. This is a retrospective bag. And these are just a little bit more styly, kind of nice look to them. They're a little floppier. I like the Mirrorless Mover for protection, but when I want to look good, the retrospective bag. If you don't find anything by ThinkTank, you could look up a company called Peak Design. They also make really cool bags. And also, Tenba is one of my favorite camera bag companies. Now, you should know about camera bags. They come in a couple of different styles. This is a messenger bag style. Messenger bag is on the side. That's my favorite kind. But photographers also, camera bags, not photographers, camera bags also come in backpack form, which is kind of inconvenient because it's good to carry stuff on your back, but when you want to make any changes, a backpack bag isn't super great. But between those two, messenger and backpack, is a sling bag. A sling bag is a kind of backpack like this, but what happens is anytime you want access to your lenses or camera, you just sling it around and it opens up here. So a sling bag is a great gift. A hydro flask. This is not photography related, but I just love this bottle. The hydro flask water stays cold all the time. Not sponsored by Hydro Flask. Okay, another great gift under $100 is either a camera strap or a camera strap system. So some of the ones that are popular, if you look up anything by Peak Design, they make a whole camera system with clips. I use one called Optek USA. And all my cameras have the little Optek USA clips. Let me show you what they look like. See these little clips right here? Well, you can clip on. What's great about them is anytime I want a neck strap, I can clip on my Optek USA system like this. So I have a neck strap. So if I'm walking around, I have a little neck strap. But if I want to take it off and put it on a different camera, all my cameras have the same clip. So if you have a photographer with multiple cameras, that's kind of cool. And also, you can go from a neck strap to a little wrist strap. So if you want to get a little fancier, you could get your photographer person a leather strap. And this one is by a company called Due North. And when you first come, they're all stiff and stuff, but they break in so nice and they're really styling. They have colors, they have different looks to them. And so a wrist strap is a good, like a fancy wrist strap by Due North is a nice gift. Okay, next, if your photographer person is starting to work with lights or speed lights, look up stuff by Rogue. Two of my favorite things is the Rogue Flash Bender. You put this on top of a flash and it gives you more light. You can block light with it. This I use with my professional work all the time. Rogue makes a lot of accessories for flashes. This is a Rogue, what's it called? A grid, which makes a little like a beam of light. So look up stuff by Rogue. Now, most cameras that photographers shoot today, digital cameras, even though the person's doing photos, most of them shoot video, but photographers don't really use video too much or don't know about audio. So one of the first upgrades is the audio if they start shooting video. And one of the easiest and cheapest microphones, which sound great, is the Rode Video Micro and the Dailie Mini D4. These two little guys, they don't need any batteries. You plug them into your camera, go to video mode, and you have great audio. And so this is a good starting point for your photographer person that maybe wants to shoot some movies, or maybe you want them to shoot more movies and they don't care about the kids anymore because they go out and do photography. The Peak Design Capture Clip. I did a review of this capture clip thing. It's on sale now, by the way, but it's a little mount you put on your camera. Here it is at the bottom of this Fujifilm X-T3. And what's cool about this little mount is you have a clip and you can always clip the camera onto a backpack or a belt. Now, if you have a young photographer that has just been taking pictures and needs and hasn't been editing them at all, you can invest in sort of software. So Adobe has a subscription service. So for the $100 mark, it's about a year or so, a little less than a year. So that's one thing you can give as a gift is what you want to give them with the Adobe suite is Lightroom and Photoshop, which is $10 a month. That could be one direction. Another popular one is a little bit more expensive, Capture One. A lot of professionals use Capture One, but it's very powerful. There's also free Capture Ones, by the way, not a gift, but there's free Capture Ones if the person wants to try it out first. And as a third option is Luminar. Luminar is like a less expensive photo editing. I think with those three options, you could decide what's best for the photographer. They all kind of do the same things. But most professionals use Lightroom and Capture One for their workflow. So you have to assess, and Luminar is a little bit more like consumery, beginnery, and it's cheap. So you might want to do Luminar for them if they're just starting out and aren't that serious. And if they're getting serious, the other two are probably a good starting point. A book is always nice, and Dramatic Portrait by Chris Knight is a great lighting book on how to get amazing portraits and direction of light and quality of light. And so this is a cool book as a gift. A Wacom tablet. If your photographer's getting a little serious with editing, it's nice to move from the mouse and the keyboard to actually using a small tablet. The tablet comes with a little pen and it allows you to like brush on there, and it's a new way to work and edit photos. So this also brings me to if they have an iPad that supports an iPad pencil. I love editing with a pen or some kind of stylus, so it's kind of a new way to edit. So the iPad pencil or the Wacom tablet is a great $99 gift. All right, I hope that gave you some ideas of what you could buy a photographer for the holiday season. Thanks for watching.